Happy Valentine's Day to everyone except me. Yep, I'm single this year for Valentine's Day. I mean, come on, who wouldn't want this?
You hear that, everybody? I'm single.
Anyway, to remind myself of how single I am, I watched every single rom-com released this weekend, and by everyone, I mean three of them, and one surprise review at the end. I don't know if there's more, so you're only getting three, and one surprise review at the end. I can only watch movies while eating a tub of Americone Dream that's covered in my own tears so many times. Anyway, enough about my sad, pathetic life. Here are all the movies I'll review. So let's start with...
Owen Wilson?
Marry Me is most certainly a movie. It has acting, lighting, cinematography, a script. It has everything. Moving images were projected onto a screen. The movie is about as fine as a rom-com could get, but like, are we just gonna ignore the fact that this is a ripoff of Notting Hill? It's literally Notting Hill. Guy meets famous woman, they fall in love. Hugh Grant wants a word. I legit kept thinking about that throughout the entire movie, it was so distracting. Also, why is it so easy for Owen Wilson to get famous women to marry him, but when I do it, I get kicked out of concerts?
Jimmy! You smell like a winner! You
smell like you! Anyway, Owen Wilson and Jennifer Lopez do genuinely have very good chemistry, and I find their love to be extremely believable. I especially love what they did with Jennifer Lopez's character. They could have made this character a diva and incredibly insufferable, but actually no. She's a very down-to-earth and kind woman who believes she made the right choice with Owen Wilson. It made me love the relationship. Yes, it is every romantic comedy ever made, and I knew exactly where it was gonna go, and it bothered me. And yes, I'm still not over the fact that it's a ripoff of Notting Hill. It's still a charming movie, even if I'll never watch it again. Hey, it's a new A24 film! This is the new movie from Josephine Decker, who is a director I've been very interested in. I loved Madeline's Madeline, and I loved Shirley. With this one, it feels a bit more mainstream than her other works, but her style is still there. But it's still a bit weird. Like, the general audience is not used to this style. And that's fine, it doesn't have to be for everyone. I've seen this movie twice, and honestly, I've grown to really like it. Which makes me in the minority, apparently. I feel like Josephine Decker's style really works here. It feels incredibly fantastical and imaginative, almost as if we're experiencing what the main character is imagining, if that makes sense. The colors specifically stand out. It's almost like you're walking into a dream. It's so cool to look at, but there's something kind of sad about it. And I think a lot of it has to do with how the film deals with the topic of grief. The character of Lenny is someone who is very irritable, reckless, and very clearly depressed. And I feel like the only way she can truly be happy again is in her imagination. And I thought that was handled really beautifully, and performed really beautifully by Grace Kaufman, who will become a star, mark my words. Also, she played the daughter in Resurrection? Get her more roles! My biggest complaint though is that I never felt the chemistry with anyone, especially the romance. Since this is a video about romance movies, the romance is... there. It exists within the movie. I'm never going to think about it again. Also, is it me or does this movie feel so long? It's an hour and 40 minutes, and it feels over 2 hours. Flaws aside, this movie makes up for it by adding many beautiful moments, especially the final minute and the final shot paired with the music. I'm going to think about that for a long time. Alright, I know we just got through talking about a weird A24 romance movie, but I think I Want You Back is honestly my favorite of the movies that I watched this weekend. I know! This one is pretty much every rom-com ever made, so what makes this good? Well, for starters, Jenny Slate is probably my celebrity crush when it comes to movie stars, so I always love seeing her. And also, this movie has Charlie Day, who I also like. It's also from the director of Big Time Adolescence, which I also liked. So this movie, for me anyway, had quite a bit going for it. And I had a lot of fun with the movie. Charlie Day and Jenny Slate have really great chemistry to a point where I wouldn't mind hearing them banter for hours. They're both really funny, and when the emotional elements kick in, they both pull it off so well. When the emotional elements kicked in, I genuinely felt bad for both of them. These characters are really well written and fleshed out to a point where the movie weirdly feels kind of relatable. it is still pretty much every rom-com ever made, but even with its cliches, it didn't feel annoying or boring. In fact, when the movie ended, I was completely satisfied with what they did. I really do love that ending. My biggest problem with the movie, however, is that it's almost 2 fucking hours long. Why? Why do some comedies feel the need to go on for that long? This is literally just about two people who help each other get back together with their exes. That's an hour and a half long plot at most. Also, there are a few jokes here that really don't work. Like, it's not cringy. It's just like, really, that's the best you could come up with? But overall, I did really enjoy this. I usually tend to enjoy any romantic comedy Jenny Slate is in, so the pattern keeps going. Check it out on Amazon Prime. Alright, I'll throw in the surprise movie that I saw on Valentine's Day, mainly because I want to vent about it, and that movie is Dog, starring
Channing Tate, yum!
What a great fucking title. Tells you everything you need to know about how this movie will play out. I saw it by myself at an early screening and
your film stunk!
The only genuine compliment I can give it is that the ending is nice and the dog is cute. That's it. This movie has a protagonist that's honestly a huge asshole, and it's clear that you're supposed to like him. He's a charmless asshole who screams at drugs and literally threatens to fight the dog. I get his character probably has head trauma, but it's never explained, and you're clearly supposed to think that he has this charm to him, but there's honestly nothing worth liking about him to me. This movie should have just been wholesome fun. It's a fucking dog movie. But honestly, this movie is kind of offensive and gets pretty racist at points. Like, I didn't know military dogs are supposed to point out and attack Muslims with the intent to kill. Oh, and by the way, let's make fun of blind people. Oh, and by the way, let's have Bill Burr's character literally say a racial slur. There's even a scene where they make fun of and attack liberals. Listen, I hate politics, but come on. I don't want to be that guy who says this is offensive, that's offensive, because it's just a movie after all. But this movie genuinely goes too far at points, and it thinks it's being wholesome. It seriously thinks it has this heart of gold, but it feels like something Pure Flix would make. Is this God's Not Dead 4? Dog's Not Dead? This movie just annoyed me. It's not funny, it's not charming, it's racist, it's offensive, and most of all, it's boring. It is so boring. I didn't like it. Alright, there you have it. Those are the movies I watched on Valentine's Day weekend. I have no life, here are my socials. And don't forget to subscribe. Alright, thank you. Bye-bye.
And that's